Hey guys, Nicole here with Obscure Reptiles and Caging, and today we are going to be debunking some things about ball pythons. So let's get started. Hey guys, so today we're going to be talking about ball pythons. My wife actually gave me the idea for this video. She said that it would be kind of cool to go over some things that she's heard, that I've heard, things that are not true about ball pythons, kind of debunking some things that are out and about in the reptile community, people who really don't know much about ball pythons. So number one is people like to call ball pythons pet rocks. I can tell you that that's not true. Hopefully she's not super feisty, but there she is waiting right on the outside of the cage. This girl has always been a little bit of a hassle. This is Mauve, our purple passion girl. Super feisty. And just by looking at her, you'll never know that she just had 11 eggs for us just about a week ago. So she's super feisty. She is never a pet rock. And that's actually how and why we got her, is somebody couldn't handle her, said how aggressive she could be. And the truth is, she just really doesn't like to be handled. Normally she's hissing. I'm actually really impressed that she's not. But she is literally the complete opposite of a pet rock. And she almost just got me. There's her hissing. when it comes to ball pythons, some of them just don't like to be held. Some don't like to be touched. She's still hissing even though she's in her cage. But some ball pythons are very nervous, very timid, especially when they're younger. With any of these guys, they'll ball up. It's kind of hard to get them eating, stuff like that. But when it comes to especially adult females, I don't really have too many that are that timid, that pet rock that people like to say. Some of these, I can open the cage, and if it's feeding, and I've already fed a couple, so they hear, they smell, all that kind of stuff, they will fly out of that cage, and it is a little bit stressful on feeding day sometimes, especially when these guys are building follicles, they're getting bigger, getting closer to actually getting ready to have eggs. They really are all about that food. So I'm going to say pet rocks is not true when it comes to ball pythons. I see a lot of people who go to like pet stores and stuff for a lot of their information. They say that these animals are best in glass tanks, like a fish tank, or sometimes a terrarium. You can have an animal in a terrarium, especially a ball python, but these guys are very specific on their humidity and their temperature. A bin like this, it doesn't seem like much, but something like this doesn't seem too big, but it is actually almost 3 foot by almost 2 foot by, I think it's 4 inches, 4.5, 5 inches tall. That is perfect for a ball python. These are a terrestrial species. That means they stay at the ground. They do not climb. They're not arboreal. They're not up in trees most of the time. They stay nice and low. So when you do something like this and then you throw in something like this, these are a couple of hides. You throw appropriate size hides in. Sorry, I need a little photo there. We got a female who I think is gonna have some eggs. By the way she's laying, we should be having eggs here very shortly. But if you also give a water dish that has a hide in it, like we do, which has a whole lip around it, it makes these guys way more comfortable and they can be totally fine in cages like this. We actually pick the bins. You can pick clear or ones like this because it's nice and dark and it makes an animal feel secure. So in the wild, ball pythons normally are hiding. They're waiting for something to walk by and then that's when they feed. But you put them in something that's glass where they're always seen all the time, that's not always the best. On top of that, it's very hard to hold proper temperatures and humidity when it comes to glass tanks. So can you make a glass tank or terrarium work for a ball python? Yes, you can add lots of hides. It can be appropriately sized. You can hold the proper humidity if you're doing daily maintenance and you could have good temperature. But for the normal person who doesn't want to put that much work and effort into something that could be more expensive, you could do something cheaper like a rack, like a PVC enclosure with like a glass front, stuff like that. So are these animals always best in glass? No. The majority of people I've ever seen with glass who just do a little tiny water dish, a little tiny hide, and that's it in a glass tank, that's not always the best for these animals. So I would always recommend something like a rack, but is glass best for them? No. Totally debunk that. 9 times out of 10, glass is not appropriate for them. So I've also heard that ball pythons will grow to the size, for example, of their tank enclosure. Completely not true. The girl that we just showed you, Mauve, she's actually 6 years old. You saw how long she was. Most of these guys are breeding, but one of our adult females can be this long and this big around. They don't stop growing just because you're giving them a smaller enclosure. So keep that in mind when you are getting a ball python. Males tend to be a little bit smaller. They're not as food aggressive most of the time, and they can be in smaller enclosures. Like, for example, this is a 28 quart. You just saw me hold up the 31, or the, technically it would be like a 42 quart. So the female cage is just like this, but it's 2 foot instead of 1 foot. So ball pythons, the males do stay smaller normally, and they can normally be held in a little bit smaller of an enclosure. So will your animal grow to, you know, size of its cage? No. But they will be different sizes based on their gender. Next thing we've heard quite a few times is these animals are very cheap, very inexpensive. If you are getting a normal, you're going to a reptile expo, you could get one for $25, $45, $55. Yes, very cheap to begin with, but those animals are going to need different size cages throughout their life. A baby ball python, you get something, you're going to want something very small, like these are 6-quart bins. Next size up is 12-quart bins. Then the one I just showed you, which is 28-quart. And then if you've got a female, you want something larger, which is this equivalent to a 41-quart. So you're looking at 4 different cages for that snake's lifetime. Different size heat tape, bulbs, fixtures, the things that they're, you know, different size hides, different size foods. So these are not super cheap animals. You can have, for example, a ball python much cheaper than a pet cat, pet dog, stuff like that, but the initial getting into it can be pretty expensive. Or the upkeep on the animal, it's not going to be incredibly cheap. It's going to be a cheaper pet, but it's not going to be, you know, like dirt cheap, like you just have a pet goldfish. So keep that in mind when purchasing these animals. Kind of going along with the same thing, people I have heard quite a few times is these are kind of like throwaway pets. These are like things that you can get for your kid, and then in 3, 4, 5 years they're gonna die, you get them something different. These are not like a pet rat or a pet guinea pig who only lives, let's say, 5 to 15 years. Ball pythons can live 40 years in captivity. That means if you get your 10-year-old kid a ball python, they could still have that snake when they're 50 years old. That is a huge commitment. So do not ever get a ball python unless you are committed, your child is committed, you have other people who could be committed if something happens and you can't have this animal anymore. Doesn't matter if you're getting just a plain old normal, super cheap at a reptile show, or you're getting like a crazy high-end $2,000 ball python, they can live 40 years. It's a very long commitment. You're gonna be feeding them weekly for 40 years. So make sure you totally understand that, but people all the time make it seem like these are super easy animals. Okay, I've done 2 weeks of research, I'm ready to get one. Keep in mind, 40-year commitment. So these are not throwaway animals, completely debunked. The next thing I've heard quite a few times is these are very easy animals. These are really not beginner animals or beginner reptiles for people. They have to have very specific humidity, temperature, enclosure size, hides. They've got a ton of requirements. We've got whole care guide videos if you're interested in that type of stuff, but especially with just the temperature and humidity alone, if you are someone who's never had a reptile before, I would highly, highly recommend a corn snake. They stay a much smaller body size compared to a ball python. They get about the same length, but they are very good with lower temperature. Doesn't mean you should keep your corn snake lower temperature. Their hot spot should be correct. Their basking area should be nice and warm with exact temperatures. We've got also corn snake care guides too for you guys who might be interested in something like that. But they tend to accept fluctuation a little bit better than ball python. So newer people who haven't had reptiles before, things might fluctuate a tiny bit. You want to make sure your animal is in the proper setup, proper care, proper temperatures, but ball pythons are definitely not snakes for beginners. They can be very picky, and if you don't have everything exactly right, you do one little thing wrong, they can completely go on a food strike, which is not what you want. So they are not good beginner animals. All right, so I've heard quite a few people say, like my wife, for example, is that ball pythons have live births. They actually do not. Here's a picture of some clutches. They actually have eggs. The eggs are actually pretty large. They kind of are a little bit bigger than, like let's say if you, instead of a chicken egg, they're kind of the size of like a duck egg, but they're very soft to the touch, very leather-like, but they do not have live births. I've heard that quite a few times. Those would be like boas and other things like that, but ball pythons specifically have eggs. People, like for example, my mom, they think that ball pythons are very slimy, very cold. If your animal is in the proper cage, proper setup, proper care, they're normally pretty warm to the touch and they're very smooth, and it's the scales that you feel. They're very soft-bodied animals. They're not slimy whatsoever. Even if they're in their water dish, water kind of like turns into droplets and falls right off them. They are very warm. They're very smooth. They're not slimy in the slightest. And the last thing that I've heard so many times, and it is completely not true, is if any of you guys have ever heard the story, completely made up, but there's a story of somebody who has had a ball python or a boa, or insert any kind of snake that somebody wants to in the story. And they say, we'll just say some random girl has a pet snake. She lets it out of the cage, lets it do what it wants, and every night it lays next to the person in a straight line. And after weeks of this, the person takes it to the vet or talks to someone or whatever, and they say that the animal is sizing that person up to see if they can actually eat them. That is completely not true. When it comes to a snake being able to, let's say, consume a human, you're talking about a huge, huge snake. Even like a boa constrictor, who at most can get like 12 feet long, that is not something that can consume a human. Things very, very large, a very large body snake can easily hurt a human, especially if you have them around your neck, you're alone, stuff like that. But ball pythons, you're talking 6 foot long at the max. You're talking, a ginormous different kind of snake. For example, we're in New York State. You can't have anything pretty much that can kill you in New York State. You can't have a lot of things in New York State. So that is not something that you would ever even have to worry about. But I hear that story all the time. As soon as I tell people I have snakes, I hear that story. It comes out. That story is not true. If a snake's trying to consume something, it's trying to consume something. But even our 6 foot long female ball pythons like this, most of them are scared of medium or even large rats. A lot of them have to get small or they won't eat. They're too scared, they hide in the back. They're very shy, very skittish. They're not gonna hurt you. Nothing like that story is true, but I hope this debunked a couple of myths that I have heard about ball pythons. If there's ones that you guys have heard and you would like to know the truth about it, make sure you put it in the comments below. But that's it for this video. We make a couple of videos every single week, so I'll see you guys in the next video.